Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to today's nightmare build challenge. Don't know what happened to a lot of my footage. I'm assuming OBS was just like, no, I'm not doing it, even though my game worked perfectly fine. So, not for sure. But anyway, so we are attempting the one tile bigger challenge, or one room is the tile bigger challenge again. But this is a little bit different because Little Simsy did go through and make it to where this was one tile wider, basically on each side, instead of just doing one tile bigger. So it's still a bit of a challenge for sure, because you have a lot of large rooms that were kind of hard to deal with. So not as bad as the original challenge, but still pretty awful. Now, I did attempt to go through with my whole game plan that I did the first time around and actually lay out each individual room prior to, you know, putting the house together. So I try to have some kind of game plan, even though I don't know how I feel about the outside of the house at the end of this. The front, I feel, is kind of odd, so I don't know. We'll see that here shortly, because I literally chopped out the majority of this speed build, but there will be a tour of the home at the very end. I literally recorded at least an hour of the build and spent probably 3 hours all total working on it, and I literally chopped out so much of this video that I was down to like 3 or 4 minutes of just a speed build, because it was just way too choppy. I was just over it. So anyway, I did have a lot of fun though trying to go through and furnish this home, which if you want to download it, it's in mainly like base game, eco lifestyle, and the new Snowy Escape. So there's probably like several other packs in here that I use for like decoration items. So feel free to still download it. You might have to replace a few items here or there, but it's nothing that's going to be like make or break in regards to like downloading this. Outside of those packs that I mentioned, I attempted to not use that many packs, but when I got down to the end, it just became a slippery slope of like, oh, maybe I could use this one item, just this one item. So it's fine. But anyway, I know I mentioned it last week, but I've got everything set up. I'm going to attempt to do my first Twitch stream tomorrow. Hopefully all goes well and my editing software and everything doesn't decide to screw up that as well, so fingers crossed. But if you do want to come over and watch me, I will link my Twitch down below. I'm gonna attempt to start the 100 baby challenge all over again on The Sims, so that's what we'll be looking forward to. I'm gonna go ahead and create my sim probably today, and I'm gonna use the house that we had in the previous video of our speed build, because I really enjoyed that starter home, to be quite honest. I do got to make a couple of tweaks though to it, just because we're kind of need a toddler bed to begin with and not a child's bed. So I think I will probably go live around like 12 or 1 o'clock my time, and I do live on the west coast, so I'm on Pacific Standard Time. Don't know what time that is for you, but can try and look that up. And this is going to be the actual tour of the home, be able to get an idea of what it looks like after spending all the time that I did on it now that all the video was chopped out. But I don't know what kind of vibe I was going for. I did use more of like the like antique looking doors almost, but this is definitely a lot more of a modern vibe inside. So, you know, maybe a younger person bought the home, decided to renovate the whole inside. And I don't know why, but I really love this whole faux fireplace idea. I think it's mainly because an actual fireplace just didn't make sense in like any part of this room. Now, this is obviously one of the bigger rooms. I figured I could split the space up, kind of an activity room, the living room, and an office. And the kitchen area is massive as well. I figured, again, just kind of split it into two separate areas. You know, you've got your actual kitchen, you've got a small dining space, you've got the island where you could sit and eat. But it's kind of hard trying to figure out, like, how to fill out all the wall space, too. Like, I just could not figure out exactly how to do it. I don't know. You'll kind of see some weirdness with some of the pictures in the bedroom when I try to upsize them. We're just going to pretend we don't see that. So this does have a kid's bedroom. So obviously if you download this, you can always change it around and just make it into, you know, a guest bedroom or whatever. But I really liked adding in the cute little details that we had here. I've never used that yellow bunny before, so I don't know. Just trying something new. This house is all total 2 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms. They're both full baths, so you don't have to worry about, like, you know, your sim not having a shower or something. But this one, I kind of went through and, I don't know, I try to use that one tile room to, like, the best of my ability. So I ended up turning that into a shower, which seemed like the best option. So I thought that was pretty neat. I did cheat probably a little bit with one of the rooms because I was going to turn it into a closet, but one of the walk-in closets fit perfectly in there. So I kind of just shut that into it. So it worked out well. But you're going to go into the bedroom area and see that now. But that is everything. So be sure to subscribe, leave me a like, and leave a comment down below as well on what you would like to see next. Thank y'all so much for watching though, and have a wonderful day.